other question for this is a question to the chair.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for that. Welcome to the appointments panel for the recruitment of the chief executive. Just some preliminary items. The main one being item two, members' code of conduct. Does any members wish to declare any interest? No. Okay. Thank you very much. That takes us then on to the main item, appointment of Chief Executive, Head of Paid Service, including Returning Officer and Electoral Registration Officer. Okay, we've got a report in front of us with some recommendations. Chris, do you want to just briefly take us through this report and then we'll highlight the areas where we need to make a decision?
Okay, thank you, Chair. Following the appointment committee act was set in October, the appointment set up the appointment of the chief executive. The report highlights a number of issues for discussion and board decision today, some of which are recommendations to council. The report recommends a review of the salary of the chief executive, the report also highlights the role of the returning officer and electoral registration officer at the request of the appointment committee. It outlines the requirements of the job as discussed in the process about job description for decision and outlines the process of the timetable. The report also recommends that this panel looks at interim arrangements between the retirement of the current chief executive and in the run up to that, support on to the appointment of the chief executive. So I propose, Chair, that we move to the body of the report.
Just a suggestion. I mean, the recommendations on page 6, I think, cover the main areas where we need to make a decision this afternoon. Are we okay to take each one item in turn? And obviously happy to take questions and comments and contributions as we go along. Is that okay? Yes? Okay. Before we do that, it was remiss of me to just introduce our two external advisors for this post. I'm really grateful that we've got Martin Denny, Martin from the Local Government Association. Welcome, Martin.
Thank you.
And David Slatter from Penna. Welcome, David. And you're going to be advisors on this this post. So the first one, obviously important one, is the issue about the salary for the new chief executive service. Now, obviously, in your report, you've got a whole series of appendices with some comparisons with other councils, etc., which I'll take it if everybody's had a look at them. I think I'd just like to bring David Martin in, as somebody who has probably a better appreciation than I do, certainly, of the external market at the moment and what your thoughts, your advice to us might be on in terms of salary for this post. So, I don't know who wants to go first. David?
Yeah, sure. I mean, there's two reports for salary. There's one that's to attract somebody to this role, and there's one that's also going to make sure people stay. So, there's a retention element to the salary value as well. We are looking at a marketplace that's got a lower quartile salary, which is where you are currently. So a 155 to 175 range doesn't mean you have to appoint at the top. It does give you opportunity and flexibility given the market to make sure that the quality candidates choose to come to work and more importantly stay in it. So you might have a 3 to 5 year minimum that you want that opportunity to be able to.
Okay, so that would be your recommendation. Okay. Martin, do you want to?
Really, I've looked at our data as well, which are obviously very similar, and again, it is important that you have a range with the ability to attract a range of candidates to
that's what the external advisors were suggesting, yeah.
I believe the planning and the planning is also as a
few weeks
ago, private not feeling
Phil, you want to ask?
I was asked about that as well.
Can I just ask two things? Just want some clarification on Appendix 3, where it's the chief executive pay salary to the role of the chief executive's nurse salaries. Page 13. Could I ask, are those proportions fixed or automatic or whatever? So if you appoint a chief executive on a different salary or a higher salary or whatever, do whatever the want is, would there be automatic increases in strategic directors?
Yeah, Chris,
okay.
You asked.
The percentages that are shown here are shown as percentages on the current grade. There's absolutely no recommendations within this report on at this stage around the role of strategic directors. You will see the strategic director grade actually top of the grade, and on the final is actually the bottom of the grade for the chief executive. So, in fact, increasing or reviewing the salary and hopefully to be a great more differential between the chief executive and strategic director. But there is not a percentage that means that the strategic director automatically gets 90% of the chief exec grade. That is a percentage as it stands in terms of how we do originally set it up. Those can be altered, and the discipline panel has the authority to make a recommendation to the council to alter that.
Second thing I should understand is the page 23 appendix. We had a conversation, this is page 23. Had a conversation previously when we were trying to work out how the authorities manage the next year without having them in the air. But this is probably more about all the members of staff's head. And I just wanted to know, because we pay a living wage to people in the staff and things like that, and it pays the work raise, and we want to pay our authorities to do that. So perhaps just told them what we're starting out with actually getting what hours a week, what number of hours a week, what people work out in practice, so I can just get my head around the ratios that are often commented about between the lowest and the highest in the organisation.
Okay. Page 8 shows the average of different data around averages of town equivalents in terms of average salaries, which is required to be a national policy legislation to put all that information within the pay policy. In terms of entry level, I mean the salaries that start at Adderall. Adderall Council, our pay scale started at 1.10, which now we're to 7.502 precisely per hour, with an annual salary of 14,736. Local government pay scales start differently. They start at 5.5, and following the National Pay Award, it's currently £7 an hour at £13,500 per annum. So a rural council can pay our lowest paid workers a higher entry level than other councils because of the pay level wage.
That's why I'm sure the time was a lot like the one probably 5.7.
Well, these are the averages of the ratios. So it's for every pound earned, how much does the chief exec get over times that ratio? So that is a calculation. This is an every council's pay policy through the local smack.
The top of the revenue is
heard the recommendations from the external advisor from that debate and asking questions about it. Anybody want to? Anne, did you want to come in?
Well, I do, yeah.
And I'll bring you back in.
I think it's important to recognise where we are in the local and what we want to attract here, we want to attract the best. So we've got to be somewhere in the parameters of being able to say that we're pitching our salary at such at an appropriate level to get the best field of candidates that we possibly can to attract the best in the business. I think also it would be fair to say, I'm sure we'll be doing this, we will be setting, you will be in close consultation with the chief executive, we're setting some parameters for them to look at, you know, senior management savings across the period of their tenure here. So, and part of the remodeling will also be about saving money. So sometimes you have to invest to save in the longer term. I think also it's worth saying that we need to look at the comparison with the rest of the public sector. It was reported last week that a primary head teacher in Tasmania is on a salary equivalent to £200,000. The first 150 secondary academies have got heads on over £150,000. You're talking about primary head managing a school with 250 pupils max, probably with about 40 staff. There's no comparison between managing, a multi-million pound organisation like one. So I think for those reasons for me, I will be saying we need to get this salary in the right range for the kind of caliber that we want to work with us here.
Three, one, six on page two, there's a discussion about recruiting, attracting people from next year's Down. Therefore, since in next year's Down, I think you have some information on next year's Town around the place where other councils have organised themselves. Looking at the range for strategic directors and deputies, and particularly strategic directors on page 21, there was some figures that generally come from Jonathan and the family who are long going way through them. So I also mentioned if the purpose is to attract somebody who's on the cusp of the problem, thinking of I can move up to a job somewhere and do this, then in the northwest, the differential between what's being suggested as a chief executive, being mooted at the moment, and what people in other authorities appear to be getting, if they were coming from next year back, would be quite great. Did I explain that very well?
Yes.
If people in strategic directors and authorities think 120,000 or whatever, and we think we might attract all of that, the difference between 120 or 150.
Yeah, well, my only sort of response to that is, obviously, we need to wait and see what level of candidate we got, but I would hope we would be attracting not necessarily just sort of deputies and strategic directors, but actually serving chief execs elsewhere with an excellent track record, so they could hit the ground running. So, you have to look at it in the context of what existing chief execs are paying elsewhere, as well as strategic director type government posts.
Yeah.
Jeff.
Yes, first thing I'd say to Anne is, just a bit of pain in the advice I was giving to my parents was that two wrongs don't make it right. So just because someone else is being paid announcements, we have to. And the other point I'd like to make is, again, unless we're thinking of asking for a primary head to come and run the authority, I think the fact that there might be one paid £200,000 somewhere around the country isn't really a reason for making decisions on what chief executive. So though obviously I think actually a primary head might be just based on his recall. But I think just thinking through that this person was going to earn the salary. Now my understanding was clearly that a set of proposals were being worked on, and it was going to save £1.5 million by the current chief executive, which I think Anne, you said, I think you did promise that still be delivered to us in December. in terms of a council unless you've changed your mind. So those savings, as I understand it, are already in the works and are due to be published in December. So in terms of those, some of those points that you're making them were a bit extraneous. So I think we need to focus on what is going to be required now. My understanding is the, unless I want to say the current chief executive was not too much, we can use a bit of except 130,000. I don't know whether that is your view, Phil. I know a number of colleagues have a number of issues with the current chief executive, but the salary of 130,000, he seemed to be able to save 1.5 million. I don't know why you have to increase it to 100. Why would have to be looking to pay 475,000 to do that? And equally, as Phil has pointed out, were current deputy chief executives sit within within the Northwest to increase to that much seems to be excessive to me. And I just genuinely, first of all, by experience,
to
you know, help us in the obviously very clear difficult financial circumstances we're in, with the financial challenges we've got going forward as well, and in remodeling and changing this council. You know, so I'm absolutely up with you, but we do have to pay the appropriate rent. Thanks, Chris.
Chris.
Okay, thank you. Co-chief executive is made top of the salary range, but as the deputy was just intimated, it is the public domain that he left his last council with a good intention, which is why we're doing the office. So in terms of the remuneration, there's an additional salary arrangement through his last job, including his pension. Before the salary arrangement was in place for his chief executive, I had his spot salary within that range of 30,000. But the range has not been reviewed for a number of years. Certainly not been reviewed as such, or changed previously to this, and in time I've been doing for the last 5 years.
Okay, any Adrian? Advice we've had from the Local Government Association of Pennar. I'm going to recommend that the salary range for the chief exec be agreed between 155 and 175 per annum. And I think as part of that, the second element of that should be that the final salary for the chief exec within that range be agreed by this panel as part of the recruitment process. And can I just make the sort of other comments that you're absolutely, you are right that we do need to make substantial savings as a result of your government's austerity policies. And the chief exec, whoever we recruit, one of his or her principal tasks will be to make the 70 million that we need to make over the 2 years, and a lot more than that, because we're told that the austerity is only halfway through beyond that. So I believe we can get the best good candidate. He or she will more than pay for their salary. And I think, if you look at the authorities in Merseyside and Cheshire, this is comparable with the salaries that they're charging, and we're talking about authorities run by both Conservative and Labour parties in terms of Cheshire West and Cheshire East and the Merseyside West. So I'm going to move that. Can I see if anybody can second that? So that's as an amendment.
Yes, so that you vote on that first.
That is an amendment first.
Can I just make a couple of points on that?
Of course.
First of all, we are comparing all these, what everybody else is getting across the Northwest, but as far as I'm concerned, we're not vacancies, so we're not really competing with people to build those best salaries, number one. Number two, wonder whether, given we are talking about, as I say, £1 million over 5 years, if we go on with the proposal we're making, wouldn't it be better to actually test the market? So instead of, you as the leader of the council or the administration determine what they believe the market to be. But the first thing to do is to test the market out. Get three quotes on that system. So wouldn't we actually be better off actually testing to see if the sort of candidates we might want are available at 130,000? And only then, if someone can provide evidence that those candidates aren't available, would we then seek to look at that situation? That's the way I think you would normally do it, as opposed to make a whole series of assumptions that there won't be people available for that sort of salary, and therefore up it to what I think is an astronomical figure. And one, I just have to say, one that I think the public will find difficult to understand, given some of the measures that you as an administration are currently taking.
Well, I would disagree with that as a way forward for two reasons. One is we've got our experts who know the market for chief exec and senior officers, and their advice is that our current salary will not get a high quality candidate because we are literally either at the bottom or in the very low. The lowest calls out. So we've had our external advisors who give us that information, given the current state of the market. And secondly, what you're suggesting, Jeff, would build in a delay in the process if we had to jump through that particular hoop. And I believe the priority now is to recruit the very best candidate we can as soon as we can after the current chief executive departs. So I think for those two reasons, I wouldn't be in agreement with that as a way forward. So I think we've got an amendment which I've moved, been seconded by Anne. Can I see all those in favour? And those against? So that amendment.
So that's the substantive.
That now becomes a substantive motion. Okay, can I see all those in favour? All those against? That's carried. Okay, we now need to. Sorry,
so that now becomes a recommendation.
To full council on the 8th of December.
That's not what we're doing the same.
No, that's the 15th of December. Right, so that becomes a recommendation to Council on the 8th of December. Right, can I just take you through now the other recommendations? So back to page 6, paragraph 18.1. Point 2 is the job description of person spec. Can we agree with that?
Move
on. Yeah.
Point, just one thing that was, I said I might miss it, all I have to say. This role that's now.
So which page are you on?
I'm just on the recommendation.
Oh, so that's the recommendation.
But on the, there's the 155.70. It talks about the electoral registration officer. You remind me how much you get for being the electoral registration officer on the top.
To the recommendations, so recommendation number 1 and 2, recommendation 3, the proposed process and timescales for the appointment of the new chief exec as outlined in appendix 2 and 11. Are we okay with that?
Yes.
Right. Paragraph 4, recommendation 4, recommendation again to council on the 8th of December on the appointment of an acting chief exec. Service effective from 1st of January 15 until the newly appointed chief exec takes up the position. I'm going to move on this, and if it will be approval, but I'm going to move that this panel recommends to council on the 8th that David Armstrong be appointed to the position of acting chief exec and head of pay service with effect from 1st of January 2015 until the newly appointed chief. exec takes up the position, and also David becomes deputy chief exec from the 8th of December to the 31st of December 2014. So I'm going to move that an interim, that's the interim arrangement.
Yeah, I will be very supportive of that. I think David has done the job before. So you'll experience in those terms. And I think, as you know, I think David is a first class officer that has performed incredibly well in this role. I hope he's been asked to do so. What was the point?
Well, in case he between the explain why you have another deputy chief exec, Chris.
Okay.
So it's the same person.
It's the same person. Yeah. It's the same person.
Yes. Yeah, two salaries.
Not at all. The proposal around a recommendation for the 8th of December is to ensure the continuity. The chief executive leaves on the 31st of December as his first in service. However, the person has not been in
the
should he not be in the buyer, there is a continuous deputy that will be acting chief executive on the 1st of January. So that there are different management arrangements as the continuity of the
system.
Safe it is to move David down to this position rather than all those other things that need tackling about.
Well, look, I mean, he's got some excellent officers in asset management, and I've spoken, obviously, you will have expected me to have had the conversation with him, which I have done, and he is confident that he'll be able to play this role but still do his. Still have the asset management working good hands going forward. So I have had that conversation with him. He was confident that those arrangements could be put in place.
I mean, Phil does have a reasonable relationship, or starts to be difficult, knowing the sort of person David is. And I think this is going to be partially your work. Phil, as the leader of the council, is to make sure that he doesn't.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, it's like season saw car, you will try and keep all that stuff going. So, you know, just to help him focus on the actual
problem. Okay, can we agree with that one?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then finally, recommendation. A recommendation against the council on the 8th of December on the appointment of a returning officer, an electoral registration officer effective 1st of Jan next year until the newly appointed chief exec takes up the position. And this is actually set out in paragraph 7.2 of the report, page 4. Surgitor, head of legal and managed services, appointed as returning officer, electoral registration officer until the chief exec takes up the position. And Joe Blott, appointed as deputy deputy electoral registration officer until the chief exec is in position. So I move that on 5. Is that agreed?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't think there are any other issues to build on. No? Okay. Right, okay, so no other business? Close the meeting on that one?
Yeah, because
Okay, right. And then the speaker.